Welcome, and thank you for joining us in this presentation entitled Cultural Changes and Persistence Through Holocene in Southern Brazil, the Evolution of the Garibaldino Lithic and Bone Industry. So today I will be presenting to you the results obtained by my team and I in the study of this archaeological site. And this study is part of a greater project in which we are interested in exploring potential changes in material culture through time in prehistoric groups from southern Brazil. So let me take you to southern Brazil, to Rio Grande do Sul state, where Garibaldino site is located. This is a rock shelter that has been dated to the early Holocene and presented many different elements, including lithic artifacts, bone tools, and also faunal remains, which are associated to the diet of these groups. Just to give you an idea about the environment where the Garibaldino site is located in southern Brazil, so this is an environment characterized by an Atlantic forest, by many small rivers and abundant fauna. The reason we have chosen Garibaldino as a case study is because it presents good conditions to track changes through time. So, we have good excavation records, we have good stratigraphy, and we have associated to the stratigraphy radiocarbon datings, which allowed us to track these changes through time. So, we are going to present to you the analysis that we made on faunal remains as an indication of subsistence patterns as diet, also the analysis regarding bone tools, and also the analysis regarding the lithic artifacts. For the lithic artifacts, we analyzed them using morphometric geometrics and technology. As you can see from the graph, there is a good distribution in terms of time of the bone tools. Also, the lithic materials are well distributed in the different layers of the site. And this is the distribution regarding the lithic points. We will begin showing you the results regarding the faunal remains, which were published by other authors. And these authors, they observed that there were no differences among the number of identified specimens observed in each layer. Also, there were no differences among the layers regarding the specific diversity of mammals, birds, or reptiles. The authors found out that the most important vertebrate taxa were the big lizards, birds, armadillos, and deer. We are interpreting the lack of changes in the strategies of resource exploration as an evidence of stability of these strategies throughout the Holocene. For the bone artifacts, we have identified the different types of artifacts that were made, and also the frequency of these different bone tools through the Holocene, which show no differences among the different layers. And these are the species that they were using to make these tools. Regarding the lithic points, we applied geometric morphometrics in order to further understand if there were any important changes in the shape of these points through time. So we had 94 points, and what you see there, the groups A to D, they represent the groups in terms of their chronology. And we found no significant differences between point shape and chronology, meaning that you can find different shapes in different chronologies. There are really no shapes that are exclusive or characteristic of a given date of the site. Also, when we run the correlations between shape and chronology, we find a very low correlation, which corroborates what you can see in the graph. In terms of the lithic technology, we recorded a lot of point attributes, which allowed us to identify a sequence of production of different points. Also, we run a lot of different statistical tests, and our results indicate a lack of differences through the Holocene regarding the technology of these points. One exception would be the use of agate as a raw material in the earlier occupation of the site. Also, the technological analysis allowed us to identify different types of points. In these different types, they show different technologies. So you can see there the Garibaldinense points, the Montenegro points, the Garibaldinense scrapers, which indicate a reuse of Garibaldinense points as scrapers, and also the Brochier points. In conclusion, we were able to characterize what we can call a Garibaldinense culture. That means that we have identified patterns in terms of diet, as we can see from the faunal remains, patterns in terms of the bone industry, so the types of bone tools, and the taxa, the species that were being used to make these tools, and also patterns in terms of the lithic industry. And these patterns in terms of the lithic industry, they were supported by both the morphometric geometric analysis and the technological analysis. More sites potentially presenting the same cultural features in southern Brazil are currently being studied by us. In the case of the Garibaldino site, what we can say is that the elements of the material culture that we studied, so the bone tools, the faunal remains, and the lithic industry, they present good evidence for a lack of significant changes in more than 7,000 years of occupation. It's important to say that this lack of significant changes might be a good indicator of a systematic cultural transmission happening from one generation to another. And the idea that you have strategies of these human groups in southern Brazil that are stable through time. In a sense, we can say that these groups, they might be actively avoiding changing their culture through time and maintaining what we can call a tradition. So patterns of doing things through time and doing these things in the same way. If you're interested in knowing more details about our research, I leave you here the published articles about Garibaldino. I would like to thank CAPES and FAPESP for funding our research. Also, special thanks to the organizers of this event that allowed us to present our results. And of course, I would like to thank you for watching us.